everyone, and welcome to my channel. I'm Diane Deziel, and today I'm showing you how to do the grading of a tailor sleeve or a two-piece sleeve. Now this is my tailor sleeve that I'm using for the demonstration. It comes from my tailor block that has no seam allowance, but if your pattern has the seam allowance, it's the same grading. My pattern I'm using is a size 10. And since the grading on the sleeve is not that big and we're separated in two pieces, it's quite small. So I'll grade three size larger from 10, 12, 14. I will do this size 16. This video, I'm doing it to answer a question that someone that bought my ruler, she wanted to learn how to grade the tailor sleeve. And if you look at my ruler, you could see that there is extra line inside of my sleeve. This is specially done to grade the tailor sleeve. Now the next thing we'll do is for sure trace the pattern piece that we have all around and indicate the grain line. When you do retrace your grain line, make sure you extend it on both sides for both pieces. Now if you look at the grading we have on the ruler, you'll see that you have the sleeve head grading. For the basic sleeve, you have the underarm point, and you have a few length, a short sleeve or to the elbow, and you have the bottom of the sleeve or the hem level. The extra point that I put for the tailor sleeve are over here, so you will still use the sleeve head. You have this extra point for the point of the tailor sleeve, and you have the bottom grading at the bottom of the sleeve. Today I'm going to start the grading with the top sleeve. So I'm going to place my ruler right over. I'm going to align my size 10 or my basic tracing, place it right over grain line and sleeve head point of my trace line. I'm going to align my grain line straight. And today I want to do size 16, so 12, 14, 16. I'll use the purple color. Now we're ready for the second point that is right here, and it does correspond to the contour of your sleeve right over here. So I will place the black right over the trace line at the corner. I'm going to align the grain line with the sleeve and point the purple. Now we move all the way down for the bottom point. We're going to place the black right on the contour corner right here. You're going to align your grain line, these two lines, and point the purple. I just did the point a little more apparent with the Sharpie. I'm now going to do the other side. I'm only going to have two points to grade, so this one and the bottom one. To grade on the other side, I'm going to flip my ruler. I'm going to place my black dot right over the trace line. I will align my grain line, here it is, and dot the purple. Now we go at the bottom. Same thing, I'm going to place the black right on the contour line, align my grain line right here, and dot the purple. Now we're ready to retrace the new size, so you will need your pattern. Since the grading on a sleeve is only horizontal, you could simply put your corner of the sleeve on the new point, same thing at the bottom, and trace from top to the bottom. What you'll notice is I always do a little bit the corner, top and bottom. We'll do the same thing with the other side. Now for the sleeve head, first thing I'll do is elongate the grain line, make it all the way up and down on my basic pattern. Now we'll be able to place the pattern on the grain line and move it up until the reference that we got for the grading. Just like that, make sure that your grain line is touching the grain line. And we could trace more or less 4 or 5 centimeters on each side, like 1.5 to 2 inches. Now to complete the sleeve head, what I usually do is place my pattern pretty much in the middle of the new size and the basic one. So you see the distance here, and they're pretty much the same. And you're going to trace this middle part. Then for the other side, we do exactly the same thing. Then if you have a little correction of the line to do, you do it. At the bottom, in this case, you're not going to see much correction, but usually you take your block, place it on the line on both sides, and just retrace the middle part. We're ready for the underarm piece, and you'll see we'll do exactly the same thing. Now, I said that it will be the same thing, but there is a difference. We don't have sleeve head on this piece, it's the underarm, and the underarm doesn't move up and down. So in fact, we only have 2 points to grade on each side of the sleeve. So I'm going to start my grading right away, placing my black dot right on the trace line. Align your grain line and dot the purple. Now we move to the bottom of the sleeve. I take the black dot, I place it right on the trace line. I align my grain line right here and dot the purple. Then you flip the ruler and we'll do the other side. I place my black dot directly on the trace line. I align the grain line right here and dot the purple. Now we move to the bottom. We place the black one right on the trace line. Align your grain line and just point the purple. Again, I just indicate with the Sharpie the dot so it could be more apparent. Now we just have to connect the dot top to bottom. And remember to indicate the corner for a little while. We do the same thing on the other side. Now we're going to trace the underarm armhole part. And there's a little difference here, the fixed point is going to be the underarm notch, so the single notch that is the side seam underarm point, and this remains fixed. So when we retrace, the part that is missing will go to nothing there on both sides. For this one, it's very important that you don't do the curve deeper, you don't change the shape, you're just going to stretch it until the new point. So just the top part like that. If you notice, I didn't trace all the way. I'm just going to complete the line by hand so it's soft. Then you do the same thing on the other side. Again, we complete the line by hand. For this one, at the bottom, you'll see a little bit the difference in the line. And you will see why we do the corner for a little while. So you place your pattern right over, touching both, and just trace the middle part. There you go, your size 16 is completed. From the size 10, we grade to 16. You have one last thing to do, and that we have to do for any sleeve grading. Not only the tailor, even the basic sleeve, you have to verify the position of the notch according to your bodice. You will verify from the underarm point. You must verify the notch because here when we retrace, same thing on the bodice, you position the notch by height. So when it's finished, the size is okay, you have to verify the position of the notch according to your bodice from the underarm point. There you go, the grading is complete. That's it for today. I hope you enjoy. Thanks for watching. I see you next time.